G'day. Just a quick video about quick change tool posts and parting tools today. When we get a lathe, usually comes with a tool post like this. And we can't wait until we get our hands on a quick change tool post like this. But they do come with a disadvantage. When you have a look at the tool here in the tool post, you see it's pretty well supported. But when you look at a high-speed steel blade in a holder, you'll see it's really overhung. To me, it's a bit like trying to do this, and nobody in their right mind would do that. So if you're worried about the height of your tools, get some of these, and as long as they're the same shank size, your tool height will always be the same. So you can use a set of shims that are all the same height to get exactly the height you need, and it really shouldn't be a problem then. These are some of my parting tools. I don't use the high-speed steel ones, but you can see from that the overhang does become quite pronounced. This is a tool I've used off eBay for $25. There's a couple of clips later in this video of it being used. Something like this to me at $40 is a complete waste of money. There are people who use them and recommend them. All I can say is they have a lot more skill than I have to be able to use them and get a good result. This is from a subscriber of mine who said he was having terrible trouble parting at 500 RPM. And you can see where the red arrow is pointing. The top slide is sitting on a very small diameter support. So after a bit of communication back and forth, he moved his top slide back so that the tool post holder was actually above that disc support. And he found that he could then part at 2000 RPM and it was much easier going than trying to do it at 500 RPM. This is that $25 eBay parting tool at work on some aluminium. This is from a previous video about that parting tool in particular. Now, it was mentioned in a comment on one of those videos that has since disappeared. That's the comment, not the video. That my machine, my CNC lathe, although it's small, is a fairly robust machine, and indeed it is. But that doesn't mean that you can't look for ways to make sure your machine is as rigid as possible. That was machine grade aluminium 2011, and the next clip is of free machining steel S1214. If you're not using free cutting materials on your small lathe, you really should try and get some and try it. It makes life so much easier. Now, here I'm taking a turning cut with this parting tool. I don't even know if you can do this with a high-speed steel blade. I would imagine not. I wouldn't think they have the rigidity to be able to do that, but I'm happy to be corrected. But as I say, if people can use those high-speed steel blades, they have a lot more skill than I do, and I'm just not willing to learn, put in the time to use them. In a production environment, you just got to get the job done as well as and as quickly as possible. There's a look at some chips that were coming off that. People talk about C-shape or number 6 shape chips. So this tool for $25 was working quite well. Here you can see the surface finish that I got from that parting tool. The one on the right was faced, but the other two are from within the grooves that were cut. If you visit Cutting Edge Engineering Australia, you'll see a young guy who uses a standard tool post for the rigidity that it gives compared with a quick change tool post. Have a look at his work. He does some amazing stuff. I think my chuck would fit up the bore of his lathe. By the way, I have a theory that you probably shouldn't try parting much more than 1 to 1.5 times your spindle bore if you want to be successful. I've canvassed a few proper tradesmen. Don't forget, I'm just a draftsman. But they all seem to agree that 1.5 times the spindle bore is generally a good sort of maximum to work to. A lot of them have done bigger, but they've found it a real task to tackle rather than just parting off. So don't have too high an expectation of what you're going to be able to do. Thank you for watching.